Warning. This video is intended for demonstration purposes only. Trying to duplicate the shown procedures may result in serious injury or even death. Hi. In this video, I'll try to refine 20.4 grams of gold containing various contaminants. To increase the surface area, I flattened the gold nuggets using a hammer. After cutting the flattened gold into small pieces, I placed it in a flask. To dissolve the gold, I added 120 ml pre-mixed aqua regia consisting of 90 ml hydrochloric acid and 30 ml nitric acid. On the next day, everything but a small amount of silver chloride was dissolved. To denox the solution and to precipitate any lead as lead sulfate, I added sulfamic acid. The solution was diluted with water and filtered 2 times. to precipitate the gold, I've added saturated SMB solution to the filtrate. Boiling the precipitate in concentrated hydrochloric acid. Here the things got out of hand. The color of the washing acid was getting darker and darker, resembling tea, and I concluded that the gold was going in solution again. To make matters worse, I added SMB, but the solution didn't change color and I decanted the liquid. I left the decanted washing acid in another beaker and proceeded with the water washes of the precipitate. I moved the gold to the melting dish ready to be melted. Note the sparks. Palladium. It's all making sense now. Some palladium was co-precipitated with the gold, and most of it was re-dissolved during the concentrated hydrochloric acid wash, giving the solution dark orange, almost tea color. I panicked thinking the gold was re-dissolving and added more SMB. This is not how pure gold should look like. The frosted surface is another sign of palladium presence. Moral of the story: if I followed the protocol, there would have been a different result. That means I should have continued with the concentrated hydrochloric acid washes until the washing acid stops changing color, even after prolonged boiling. Remember the decanted washing acid? I've managed to recover another 0.3 grams gold from it. By using sodium carbonate and formic acid, I also recovered the palladium. The XRF analysis of the button showed 99.1012% gold and 0.8988% palladium. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe below.